it is maybe not the retreat anymore, okay? But you must take this opportunity in the sacred land to replenish your energy and keep your discipline. Because at home you have no chance. You don't even meditate enough every day. Here you don't have anybody to trouble you. You should meditate. Karima, okay? I don't like it that you come here just to try to establish a relationship, looking for boyfriend, girlfriend. Not only troubling yourself, but pulling somebody else into trouble with you. Maybe the boy did not care about you. He did not even notice you. And then you keep coming, hanging around, trying to talk to him and this and that. And then he also falls into it with you. They are more innocent. They're naive. They do not know a woman's trap. In the old time, when the Buddha was alive, he told his monks, even if a 70-year-old woman laying, almost dying on the floor, you don't even look at her. Because I think he knows very well. Don't need magic. Some are harder, maybe, yeah. Some maybe are already married, but he has a little trouble with his wife, and then if you come along, maybe he thinks, okay. Maybe this is a time to change. And when he goes home, he doesn't try to make peace with his wife because he has something, maybe a spare part, maybe like some easy substitute somewhere. You don't try, okay? Whatever comes to you will come to you. You're trying to seduce somebody is making a lot of trouble for yourself, eh? And trouble for the poor guy. Hmm? You can easily get a guy, but to keep him is another thing, you know, and then it will give you a lot of trouble, a heartache later on. Especially if he patches up again with his wife, and then you'll be in trouble. If you don't have to take this karma, don't look for it, okay? Protect yourself. Give yourself a lot of time, whenever you can, to meditate, to think of liberation. We are here for very short. Not everyone can practice this method even. You are the lucky one, and you just kind of don't care. Then you don't need to come here anymore. Don't blame me, I'm just fair. Everybody who comes here, sit here, meditate, and you just come run, rushing in. Maybe they already settle in to meditate, and you rush next to them, clumsily fall into them, making noise and making excitement, and waking them out of their samadhi. That is not fair, okay? This time is not the time to eat or nothing special at this time, right? So you should meditate, huh? Even if you sit here not in sleeping, at least you make an effort. And heavens will notice that.
我说你们来这边要打坐，即使这个时候没什么事，应该多专心打坐，不是在外面那个一对一对这样，一对或是一群这样子聊天在外面，要惊动这边的气氛，人家进来打坐，你在外面聊天，然后看师傅来啊，就匆匆进来这样打扰别人，懂不懂？也许那个人他已经打坐了，他安静了，你一进来匆匆动动那个样子，把人家吵醒过来。 这样不公平了，来这里没有几天，应该专心修行才对，是吗？不是来这边找朋友、找男朋友、找女朋友，是不是啊？所以如果来这边不想专心修行的话，我就不让他们再来了。不要怪我怎么样，我是很公平的，OK？ 我要保护那些好的，听懂没有？你看像那个老人家，他们老了，连牙齿快没了。 哎，来这边打坐呢，还坐这里呢。来这边不是找男女朋友，或是打关系，浪费宝贵的时间。来这个很静静的、很有灵气的地方，也不打坐，回去怎么打嘛？啊，然后就说修行不好，我就是大概是这样讲了。如果
来这边不穿心修行，不澄清的话，就以后不用再来了，打扫别人，了解吗？了解。哎呀，有人打坐，你应该也一样打坐。然后我叫出来还不出来，等师傅恐吓才出去，这样子不对了，对自己没有尊重心，没有廉耻。吃饭已经到几点了？到六点是吗？ 吃饭的时候到六点，那现在这个时候没事了，来这边也没有什么工作要做，没责任，应该专心打坐才对。我讲错吗？没有。哎呀，来没有多久啊，也是很不容易才能来，有时候家人要牺牲啊，在留在家里管家管小孩，你才能来。你来这边去找人聊天的话，那何必来呢？ 师父讲对吗？讲对吗？对。哎呀，时间很宝贵呢，很多人工作啊，那个不是今天，不过昨天也要安排来，安排去哈，巴士什么都要安排，师父也要安排了，你们才能来，了解吗？我也叫他们不要拿你们的钱了，不要付钱 ，OK？ Don't have to pay for the bus ride going and coming back. I paid everything. Don't pay. It's not your fault. It's not about money, but it's not your fault. You don't have to just pay for everything. No need. Got that? I told them already, but in case you don't know, you don't pay. And if you paid already, tell them to return your money. You work very hard to earn money, and you're very sincere to come here. I don't want you to spend any extra. If I could, I would pay all your plane tickets and everything. But I cannot do everything. You know, you have to come back and forth. Because life is complicated. It's not so simple in our lives. There are regulations and laws and this and that. And there's nothing I can... it's out of my control. It's for everybody. Yeah, everybody. 我说你们在家里赚钱很辛苦，我不要你们多付额外了。OK， 那个 bus 来来去去不是你们的错。 啊，也不是谁的错了，就世界就比较没那么容易了啊，世界不简单，哎，有这个规矩，有那个规矩啊，大家了，不是我们而已，所以在背后啊，有很多组织，OK， 不是说你们来辛苦而已，他们这边也很辛苦啊，要打扫，要准备干净，然后还没来以前呢，要。 有人被派来那边打扫，弄整齐，让你们过来，了解吗？了解。然后你们也很辛苦才能到这里，很多人辛苦了，也许有一些不辛苦，辛苦不辛苦了，有机会的要打坐，要休息，是吗？要反省，哎，要看看我们有没有，一说有没有进步多少啊？打坐看看，至少要。 试看看，懂不懂？要尽力，然后就没有精力，然后这边怪说整体不好，这边要搞砸，要烦恼到别人，听懂吗？听懂。这个时候如果不打坐，应该去休息、睡觉。如果累的话，就不要在外面聊天干什么？有什么好聊天的啊？来这里有什么好聊天？在家里已经很忙了，整天聊来聊去了。 哎，要跟谁讲话都很容易啊，打一个电话就好了，何必来这边吵呢？懂吗？然后，如果男孩子他没注意你，你就来那边吵吵他，然后他也注意你，然后两个都一起掉，了解吗？伤害到别人是不对的。OK， 我本来要找过来了。I was supposed to come. I was thinking maximum 8 o'clock. 8:30, and then I couldn't come until 10, you see? Well, that's good so. Today I didn't tell anybody that I'm coming, because I worry maybe you already meditating, you know? And then I caught the whole group outside, talking like in a supermarket or socializing club. It doesn't look like an ashram. It doesn't look like a place where people are quiet, you know? Quiet inside and quiet outside, just to take advantage of these precious days, to make the best of your time here. So from now on, it's like that. If people are not sincerely wanting to meditate or practice here, coming here just to take up the space, or just to look at other people, to make more energy wasting for me, then I don't allow them to come anymore. That's what I said to the Chinese, mostly over there, Chinese people. I am not coming out here just to show up.